Hi YouTube, this is Robert Soy. Welcome to Getting Wwiser Episode 4, Ambient Ambition. As always, there will be a text version in the description below. In our past few tutorials, we were really getting into setting up Wwiser in UE4, then understanding the basics of the interface. So today, I'll show you how to set up ambient sounds, just like they have in their tutorial level. I suggest you have a headset on. Here's what the demo sounds like. As you can see, it has two examples, spatialized and unspatialized. Each has its own place in any given world scenario. I'll show you how they created both of these. So let's jump back to Wwiser and get our sound ready. We'll use water and air in this example, so we can better differentiate our sounds. We will use water for spatialized and air for unspatialized. Once again, all you have to do to import the sounds are drag and drop the sound into our actor mixer hierarchy. Now let us set up each sound individually. So we'll set up spatialize first. Remember, in mine, it is water. I'm setting mine to loop infinitely in the General Settings tab. Now go to the Positioning tab. And here is where we can set up our attenuations. Click the 2D dropdown and set it to 3D. Now let us make our attenuation for it. Just click the double arrows next to the name, and then click New. Let's call this one River. Notice when we're creating this new attenuation, it's saving it in the Game Syncs tab. Now let's hit the Edit button. Now you can see this specific attenuation settings. Down below on the bottom right of the graph, it has its max distance. In other words, how far this sound will last. Then to the left are our auxiliary sends, as well as high and low pass filters. These settings can be chosen to be kicked on or off at certain distances. Then there's the graph, which you can use to simulate the sound at any given distance in real time. That is what I am doing in the video right now. As you can see from the video, you can mess with this curve any way you want. You can add in different points to where you want it louder or softer. Notice when I'm moving the line on the graph, the circle below it also corresponds to the distance. Now let's talk cone attenuation. The demo they gave us doesn't use this, but I'll show it off a little here. When you take this on, notice how the circle below the max distance becomes different colors. Where it is gray, the sound is unaffected by an LPF, while behind it and on its sides, the LPF starts to kick in. This is especially useful if you want a sound to point in a specific direction. As a side note, the RTPC tab in this is only used for the cone attenuation. Now let's add in a low pass filter to really get this sound to sound a little bit more organic. We will have it so it kicks in when we are far away to give the effect that we are even farther than what it seems. To add new points on the graph, just double click anywhere on the line. Now we can close this out. Now let's look at our other options. We don't need to mess with modes. There are two other choices for position source though. User defined and game defined. We will want game defined. In another tutorial, I'll show you some special tricks with user defined. We will want to update at each frame as well. And spatialization is just as easy as a checkmark. Now let's set up unspatialized. We don't have to do anything different, just to make sure that the spatialization text box is unticked. So I'll quickly go through setting up air, remembering to set it to loop infinitely and adding an attenuation graph to it. What I'm doing in the video now is exactly the same as what we did earlier. I'm just checking to make sure that it sounds all right. Now let's make a new play event. Remember, it's just right-clicking the sound and clicking new play event. Also, today I'm going to show you another way to make a new play event. Go to the Events tab, right-click and click New Child. Click Play. Now drag and drop our sound into that play event. Now we're ready to set this up in a UE4 level. This level I have created before the demo. Don't worry, it's pretty simple. I've laid out a place for the river and for the air. Now let's drag and drop our new play events from the event player into UE4. Remember to save in Wwiser before you do so. Remember, before we can have these sounds play in UE4, we have to set them up to have a bank, and then, under the Build tab, click Generate Sound Banks. Good! Now the sounds are ready in UE4. Let's go to the Modes tab and find the AK Ambient Sound Volume. We can now directly drag and drop this into the scene. If we already have a sound selected, it will automatically use that sound. Otherwise, we can choose which one it is on the right-hand side. In the video, I accidentally clicked the wind sound. I'm just going to quickly change it over to the water sound. On the other hand, we can just as easily drag and drop our AK event into the scene and it will automatically be converted into an ambient sound. Right now in the video, I'm just centering the wind sound on the platform, as well as setting up everything just the way I like it. Now we have the two sounds in our level, and you can see their influence on the level with the yellow spheres. These spheres will actually update in real time. So now let's go to Wwiser and change the max distance. Remember to click Save. When we go back to UE4, look, our attenuation sphere changes. As a side note, attenuation is only done in spheres. I checked Audio Kinetic's website to see if there were other ways. Theoretically, you could set up something with RTPCs, but there are no presets, and that was the official answer. I'll leave a link in the description below. In the video, I'm just re-clicking Generate Sound Banks one more time to make sure that all of the attenuation changes were updated. Now let's set up the level blueprint. Start with adding an event begin play. Now let's select our river sound and add a reference to it in our blueprint. Just make sure that you have it selected, and when you right-click it, it will allow you to add a reference in the blueprint. Now let's draw a line out from the event begin play. From there, choose Audio Kinetic. And from under Audio Kinetic, choose Ambient Sounds, and then Start All Ambient Sounds. Now let's go from the Out tab of the Start All Ambient Sounds, and then go back into our Audio Kinetic tab and choose Set Occlusion Interval. Set the refresh rate to 0.2, and plug our reference to our river sound into the actor. Now click Compile and Play. Now let's set up a blocking volume. It's just as simple as dragging and dropping it into the level. The reason why we use set occlusion in our spatialized actor is so then it can interact with the blocking volume and other such things in the level. Blocking volumes are invisible, but they block sound as well as movement. And that concludes this lesson of Getting Wwiser. Next time I'll show you guys more about play events as well as cool things we can do with the attenuations. In that tutorial, we will replace the gunshot sound with our own. Thank you for watching, and see you guys next time!